गुड मॉर्निंग माई ऑल डियर 11th स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर नेम्ड बिजनेस रिकाउंसिलेशन स्टेटमेंट, सॉरी बैंक रिकाउंसिलेशन स्टेटमेंट. इट्स ऑल्सो कॉल्ड बी आर एस. ओके, सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द चैप्टर लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस समथिंग अबाउट दिस चैप्टर. एक्चुअली अ बिजनेस मैन हैज टू टाइप्स ऑफ बुक्स. वन इज कैश बुक and the other one is passbook. In passbook, the entries are done by the bank. And in cash book, there is a column named bank. When we were studying cash book, we have studied that there is 3-column cash book. In that, there is a column named bank. Okay. So, the balance of bank column of cash book and the balance of passbook should be same, should be equal. But due to some cases, many times their balance doesn't tally. What are the reasons? Suppose we have given a check to Mr. A. And Mr. A just lost that check. It means the payment will not be received by Mr. A. We thought that our bank account will be debited by some rupees, means minus. But in passbook, there is no entry. It means the balance of cash book bank column and the balance of passbook is different now. There are many other reasons too. We will move to them further. So, let's start. So, for making that balance equal, we prepare a statement that is called bank reconciliation statement. So usually, all the firms open a current account with a bank, and in order to record the transaction, enter into with the bank, maintain a bank column in the cash book. Okay. Bank also opens a separate account of each firm in its ledger and interest all the transaction in it periodically. Okay, bank supplies a copy of the firm's account in its ledger to the firm for information. This copy of firm's account is supplied by the bank is called bank passbook or bank statement. Okay, since all the transaction entered into bank are recorded in both the books, there should be no difference. Means the balance in cash book bank column and the balance in passbook should be same, but due to some cases there are many incidents when their balance will not be tallied. So for making them tallied or for making them equal, we prepare a statement that is called bank reconciliation statement. Okay. Since all the transactions enter into bank, okay. On the other hand, when money is withdrawn from the bank, firm returns it on the credit side of bank column, okay. And same time, bank also entered the debit of the firm's account in the book. Hence, all the entries recorded in the debit side of the cash balance must tally with the entries recorded in the credit side of passbook. But As I have already told that due to some cases, these balances will not be tallied, and at that time we have to prepare bank reconciliation statement. Okay. Now I will tell you the causes or differences in the cash book and passbook balance. Difference caused by time gap in regarding transaction means if we have given a check to Mr. A today and Mr. A have forgotten to put that check in their bank account, it means the time gap. Difference caused by errors committed in regarding transactions. We have given the check of 10,000 and by mistake we have written it only 1,000. Okay. Differences caused by time gap. These are the differences. Check issued but not printed for payment. We have issued a check to Mr. A and he hasn't deposited that check in their bank account. check paid into bank for collection but not yet collected by the bank. We received a check from Mr. A and we have submitted it to our bank, and due to some cases that check is not been credited till now. Check paid into bank for collection but dishonored. We have received a check from Mr. B and we have deposited that check in our bank account, but that check became dishonored, so our balance will not be tallied. Interest allowed by the bank, if bank is allowing the interest and we don't have any type of information regarding that, we will not credit that amount and there will be differences. If there is overdraft and bank is charging interest on overdraft, bank charges and commission, okay. Due to these terms, there will be differences in cash book and passbook. Okay. And now, differences caused by errors committed in regarding transaction. So these are the errors. Means check issued to a creditor but forgot, omitted to record in the cash book. Check deposited into bank and omitted to record in cash book. Error in totaling or balance, okay. And error by of the transaction means the different entry is gone to the different account. Okay. So due to this problem, our balance will not be tallied. And for that purpose, for making them tallied, we have to prepare bank reconciliation statement. In the further videos, we will know the importance of the bank reconciliation statement, and after that, we will come to the practical. Till now, try to learn the theory part of this chapter so that you can understand this chapter quite easily. Till then, bye-bye.